Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Morrowind. Last time, when we left off, we had finished the main quest, and I had just accepted the 4 Grandmaster writs on behalf of the Morag Tong. I'm going to take care of those, but first, I want to go revisit Gendralla Laren in Aldrum, because I've spotted that it's a known bug for her not to give you her quest, and there is a workaround in the console. I just need to track her down, and I need to go to the console and use add topic strange man. And now we can speak to her about a strange man. Goodness, is he dead? How unpleasant. Was it very dangerous? I'm sorry, I really have nothing to give you but my thanks, but I'll tell everyone how kind and brave you were to help me. Journal updated. And what you get for that is a reputation point. I told Gendralla Laren that I had to kill the strange man who had invaded her house. She was grateful and promised to tell everyone how kind and brave I'd been. Alright, now let's take care of our 4 Grandmaster writs. I think, just based on convenience of location, I'm going to go to Nissus and kill Baladus Demnavani first. So obviously 3 of these 4 characters are important in some capacity in the main quest or in other quest lines, which is probably why you're locked out of the Grandmaster writs until you finish the main quest anyway. One thing I never did was read through my honorable writs of execution. Baladus Demnavani. The aforementioned personage has been marked for honorable execution in accordance to the lawful tradition and practice of the Morag Tong Guild. The bearer of this non-disputable document has official sanctioned license to kill the aforementioned personage. Then we've got Drambero. The aforementioned personage has been marked for honorable execution in accordance to the lawful tradition and practice of the Morag Tong Guild. The bearer of this non-disputable document has official sanctioned license to kill the aforementioned personage. Mistress Thorana. The aforementioned personage has been marked for honorable execution in accordance to the lawful tradition and practice of the Morag Tong Guild. The bearer of this non-disputable document has official sanctioned license to kill the aforementioned personage. And Larius Varro. The aforementioned personage has been marked for honorable execution in accordance to the lawful tradition and practice of the Morag Tong Guild. The bearer of this non-disputable document has official sanctioned license to kill the aforementioned personage. Alright, so we can taunt Baladus into attacking us, because I don't want to get expelled from House Telvanni by attacking him. Journal has been updated. Baladus Demnavani has been slain according to the traditional and honorable doctrine of the Morag Tong. None dared to report my actions. Let's see if he's got anything on him that I need. Oh, I might reclaim the Ring of Dark Mazalf. I don't need those books. Okay. Next, I'm going to do Mistress Thorana. I have to get to Tel Brenora for that. I forgot I really don't need the Bolatus writ anymore. I forgot to leave it next to his body. That has no real effect on the game at all, of course. It's just the signature I kind of stumbled onto. But make no mistake, I do rather like. There she is. Are you here to show me that thing you did, or did you want to feed the spiders? Journal updated. Mistress Thorana has been slain according to the traditional and honorable doctrine of the Morag Tong. None dared to report my actions. So I think her writ should be in the middle. We can reclaim Ariel's bow. Okay, which I will do, and now I'm going to go to Vivek and eliminate Drambero. In case you forgot, he's up in the Haunted Manor in St. Olm's Plaza. You are welcome in my home, Hortator. Oh, he's being so friendly, and I'm still gonna kill him. Hard to sever the thread of prophecy when all the prophecies have already been fulfilled, I would say. So yeah, we've gotta kill his entourage as well as him. So we might as well check all their bodies. Drambero has been slain according to the traditional and honorable doctrine of the Morag Tong. None dared to report my actions. Make sure I drop the right writ. And lastly, we can return to Balmora, and then head over to Fort Moonmoth to deal with Larius Varro. Larius Varro has been slain according to the traditional and honorable doctrine of the Morag Tong. None dared to report my actions. And Larius's weapon is the final artifact we need to grab on Vardenfell. It is his sword, Temreki, Shackler of Souls. Cast when strikes, absorb strength, absorb endurance, and soul trap. Pretty bomb-ass enchantments, really. He doesn't have anything else I particularly care about. So, let me simply repair my gear. Oh, oops. I'm gonna do this twice now. It's alright though. Does not bother me. Recall back home. We'll drop off Temreki and Oriel's bow and the Ring of Dark Mazalf. Don't need that last writ. I need two more hammers. And we can report back to the Moragtong Guildhall to get paid. Baladas. You have honorably executed Baladas Demnavani. Your work will become Moragtong legend. Journal updated 5,000 gold. Drambarrow. You found and honorably executed Drambarrow, Grandmaster. Your work is excellent as always. Journal 3,000 gold. Larius Varro. Excellent work, Grandmaster. I heard how cleverly you killed Larius Varro. As you are the Grandmaster and the executor of the writ, the full payment must go to you. 4,000 gold. And Mistress Thorana. You have honorably executed Mistress Thorana, a most dangerous foe. I am impressed, Grandmaster. Please accept the payment for this writ. Journal, 10,000 gold. I reported the honorable execution of Baladas Demnavani. I reported the honorable execution of Drambarrow. I reported the honorable execution of Larius Varro. And I reported the honorable execution of Mistress Thorana. With that, my friends, we are actually done on Vardenfell. So, it's time now. Let's see what we've got. We have the expansions. Dark Brotherhood Attacks, remember, kicks off Tribunal. We can travel to Mournhold from Ebonheart. And an island to the north and the Patchwork Airship are both Blood Moon. We will do Tribunal first. The order they were released, and really the order that sort of makes sense in line with the story. So let's go to Vivek. And then to Ebonheart. Into the Grand Council Chambers. Now, where is she? She's wandered a long frickin' way, but Asien Rain is the one who can transport us to Mournhold. Alright, hello friend, are you seeking transport to Mournhold again? Heading back, are you? Hope you've gotten all that business cleared up. Yes, please. I'll transport you right away. Good luck to you. So we end up here. We are in the Royal Palace reception area. Alright, that's just a generic royal guard. I'm an officer of the Imperial Law. Move along. You'll notice, though, they really don't like us. Look at that disposition. Background, I am a royal guard. Dark Brotherhood, that's a touchy subject, and I'm not comfortable talking about it with someone I don't really trust. I don't know why you'd want to go looking for those demons. Some say they live in the sewers beneath the Great Bazaar. Your journal has been updated. Alright, cool. Great Bazaar. You'll find the Great Bazaar in the eastern section of town. We don't want any trouble there, so mind your manners. Latest rumors. Pack rats. Really, you think I'm kidding, but Rurlus Mon is selling them in the Great Bazaar. You'd be surprised how well trained they are and how much they can carry. Cheap, too, and in a tight spot they're pretty good for stew. Little advice. Don't forget you can't levitate in Mournhold. If that's the way you're used to bailing out of trouble, it won't work here. Little secret. All the power in Mournhold starts with Almalexia at the temple. Of course, no mere mortal is going to get access to the Lady of Mercy, but Fedra Slayer, her steward, is quite approachable. Start with him, win his confidence, and then maybe things will open up for you. Fedra Slayer. Lair is one of folks in charge over at the temple. You can find him there. Morrowind lore. Mournhold is built on the site of a much older city. You won't find any evidence above ground, but down in the sewers you can find ways into the old ruins. Nerevarine. Royal Guard. I am of the Royal Guard. What can I do for you? Services. You'll find the smith Bowles Indulin at Craftsman's Hall in God's Reach, along with several other fine craftsmen. There's a healer and an imperial altar in the Royal Palace. Go to the temple for temple services. Otherwise, most trainers, crafters, and merchants are in the Great Bazaar. Oh, and we need to do God's Reach. God's Reach is on the western side of the city. There are a number of manors there, owned by some of the more wealthy citizens. You'll also find the Craftsman's Hall, which is a fine place to find armor and weapons. They'll even make them to order, provided you have the materials. You can check out the Winged Guar Tavern as well. Not a bad place for a drink, or if you need a place to stay for the night. You might check out the Museum of Artifacts as well. The curator is always trying to add to the collection. Okay. Someone in particular. Almalexia, Our Lady of Mercy, dwells in her temple. Her steward, Fedra Slayer, and the Lord Archcanon, Gavis Drin, also reside in the temple. King Hlalu Helseth and his mother, Queen Berenzaya, live in the royal palace. Tienius Deletion is captain of the Royal Guard. It's a big city. If there's someone else you want, ask around. Gavis Drin. Drin? He's the head priest over at the temple, a powerful man, and has the ear of Almalexia. Helseth. Long live His Excellency King Hwalu Helseth, Duke of Mournhold and ruler of all Morrowind. Baron Zaya. A fine woman. We're lucky to have her back in Mournhold. I know that a lot has been written about her, but don't believe everything you read. That woman's beauty is only equaled by her grace and wisdom. Shame she didn't pass that on to her son. Tienius Deletion. He is our captain of the guard. You'll find him in the throne room. Specific place. You're in the royal palace now. South is Plaza Brindisi de Rome. North is the temple courtyard and Almalexia's temple. To the west is God's Reach. To the east is the Great Bazaar. But you can't get there from here. Go through the temple or plaza first. Plaza Brindisi de Rome. You'll find the plaza in the southern part of Mournhold. It's a public place, so keep the litter off the ground. And we got a journal update. I've been told that the Dark Brotherhood is rumored to have a base in the ruins of Old Mournhold, accessible through the sewer system in the Great Bazaar. I've been warned that I enter there at my own peril. Alright, let's talk to Ephatai. Yes, do you seek transport to Vardenfell? Almalexia. Almalexia is one of the gods worshipped by the Dunmer in the Tribunal Temple. She's known as the Healing Mother and Lady of Mercy, the source of compassion and sympathy, and protector of the poor and weak. She's no tender-hearted powderpuff, though. She's an important symbol of Dunmer independence to those who resent the Empire, and the hands of Almalexia, her personal guard, enforce a strict adherence to Temple doctrines. Background. I am Ephatai, Mage. Helseth. This new ruler, King Hwalu Helseth, is trying to transform the role of King of Morrowind from a mere imperial figurehead into a powerful, personalized head of state. Athen Lethen, the previous king, was old and dignified, but few took him seriously. Helseth, by contrast, is dynamic and ambitious. Before Morrowind entered the Empire, the Dunmer had no kings, and many Dunmer prefer the old system of council rule, but Imperial partisans want a strong king along Western Imperial lines. Athen Lethen. The former king was an old man and had been ill for a while. He had no sons or daughters. Helseth is Lethen's great-nephew. Baron Zaya is Lethen's niece. Queen Baron Zaya renounced her claim to the throne, so according to Imperial custom, the crown goes to Prince Helseth. He didn't do much, but we assumed he wasn't supposed to. We thought he was just a convenient fiction for imperial administrative purposes. Latest rumors. The old King Athen Lethen is dead. Long live King Hwalu Helseth. Things are pretty grim here in the City of Light since the troubles with Dagoth Ur. Mournhold is Almalexia's city, and she's become more of a warrior queen than a lady of mercy. And there's always been hostility between the temple and the imperial administration, but since Helseth's accession, the tension between Imperial-leaning Dunmer and Almalexia's supporters is much worse. Little advice. Don't forget, you can't levitate in Mournhold. They say Almalexia doesn't want anyone's head rising higher than hers. If that's how you avoid trouble, it won't work here. You can levitate down in the sewers and ruins of Old Mournhold. I guess Almalexia doesn't go down there much. And it's also a cheap place to sleep if you don't mind the rats and thieves. Little secret. If you are looking for access to the places of power, start with Tienius Deletion, King Helseth's captain of the Royal Guard. He's fair and professional, and King Helseth is no simple figurehead, unlike his predecessor. There's real power there, and Helseth is just going to get more powerful as he learns how Mournhold works. Mournhold. Mournhold is the imperial capital of Morrowind and the holy city of Almalexia, one of Morrowind's three living gods. Modern Mournhold is built upon the ruins of Old Mournhold, which was destroyed by Mehrunes Dagon at the end of the First Era. You can reach the abandoned passages of Old Mournhold through the sewers beneath Mournhold, and adventurers still seek lost treasures in the First Era ruins. Nerevarine. The devil is dead, and the blight is gone. You have conquered Red Mountain, destroyed Dagoth Ur and all his kin. We offer you our thanks in this happy hour. Royal Guard. A bunch of thugs, that's what I say. Brought in to be the muscle for our new king. Sewers and Ruins. If you're an adventurer, you'll want to go down there. The poor and the lawless live in the sewers under the city. It's dangerous, but it's the only way to reach the ruins of old Mournhold, where the real treasure lies. I'm probably wasting my breath, but be careful down there. Maybe you think you're tough, and maybe you are, but there are things down there can kill you before you get your weapon out. Someone in particular, specific place. Transport to Vardenfell. Do you wish to go back to Vardenfell now? I can send you to Ebonheart directly. No. Let me know when you wish to return. Alright, cool. So let's look around in here. Small chest, level 50 lock. Just silverware inside. There's a door to the Royal Palace Courtyard. A door to the Royal Palace Legion Depot. Royal Palace Basement. Royal Palace Throne Room. And those there are new alchemical ingredients here. Nerthfly stalks. Sweet pulp and meadow rye, none of which have any effects I care about. Royal Palace Helseth's Chambers and Royal Palace Legion Depot. Well, shoot, that's a lot of places to check out. I don't want to leave just yet. So, let's do the basement first. Then there's a door to the palace sewers, which we'll leave alone for right now. Just a bunch of food crates there. What about this other room? Looks like just more of the same, but let's be thorough just in case. Alright, let's head back upstairs then, and let's check out the Legion Depot. Guard Captain, honor to you, Nerevarine. Background, I am an Imperial Guard Captain. Latest rumors. None of the Tribunal have been seen in public in years. I know the strain of the war with Dagoth Ur has kept them busy, but what good is it having living gods if you never see them? Little advice. If you're looking for some action, try poking around in the sewers. Be careful. Others with similar ideas also spend their spare time down there, but you look like you can take care of yourself. Little secret. I've heard that a fellow named Dovor Orin has deep pockets. He is looking for weapons and armor, special items, and he pays well. I can't tell you where to find him. Just keep your eyes out for him and his associates. Royal Guard. King Helseth's Royal Guard are an elite group chosen by the king himself. You'll find them in the royal palace. Tienius Deletion. Captain Deletion is often found in the throne room of the palace. He often confers with other members of the Royal Guard while there. Spiny Lorimore. Ooh, spell absorption. Scrib Cabbage. So lots of new alchemical ingredients. There's another passage into the courtyard. And another passage to the courtyard. Upstairs. Looks like that's all there is. So let's go there. Good grief. Okay, hold on. The end of this hallway. There's the door back to the reception area. So let's see what's over here. I want that. I want that coin. See what's in this chest. All right. Oh, hello. Shock Eater robe. That's pretty good for random loot out of a basket. Then we've got the guards' quarters. Let's head back to the reception area. And let's check out Helseth's chambers. This door is locked from the inside and cannot be opened by any means. Well, okay. Alright then, from here, we can go ahead and head to the throne room, so let's do that. Diridini Farano. I'm an officer of the Imperial Law. Move along. Background. I am a royal guard. Baron Zaya, it's so good to have the lady living among us again. She has always been a woman of the people, never putting on any airs of royalty. Okay. We also have Drusus Gratus. I'm an officer of the Imperial Law. Move along. Background, I am a Royal Guard. Baron Zaya, well, all the local Dunmer seem happy she's back. I suppose I can see why. Smart woman doesn't seem to have been ruined by royalty. Know what I mean? Okay. Back here, there are Imperial Cult Services. First, let's chat with others. We've got Ivulin Irano. I'm an officer of the Imperial Law. Move along. Background, I am a Royal Guard. Okay. We have Ivo Othraloth. I'm an officer of the Imperial Law. Move along. Background. I am a Royal Guard. Okay. And then lastly, we have Carod. Carod says nothing. Goodbye. And Tienius Deletion. He looks you over slowly and deliberately. Excuse me. Goodbye. Okay, so we can't talk to any of these people yet. That's fine. Let's head into Imperial Cult Services behind the throne. We've got Baron Zaya's chambers, the guards' quarters, Crito Olsinius. Welcome, Primate Travis. Can I tell you about our services? Or if you can donate more time and effort, would you like to become a lay servant? Spells. Oh, we got a bunch of new spells. We got drain, alteration, conjuration, mysticism, restoration, alchemy, and unarmored. Let's buy those first. Got absorb personality ranged. And absorb strength ranged. We've got masterful sublime wisdom. Masterful golden wisdom. Masterful transcendent wisdom. Masterful red wisdom. Masterful Unseen Wisdom. Masterful Green Wisdom. Masterful Fluid Evasion. And Masterful Red Wisdom. That looks like Masterful Red Wisdom is on there twice. That's alright, though. We can still chat with that dude. Background. I am Crito Olsinius, priest and disciple of the Imperial Cult. Helseth. He's our new king, I suppose. I would like to know what happened to King Athanlethen. Seems a bit odd that the old man died so soon after Helseth arrived in Mournhold. And what about Talon Vandus, Lethen's nephew? Everyone assumed he would be next in line for the throne. Until his accident, that is. Talon Vandus. Now that was a man who would have been a leader to our people. King Lethen knew what he was doing when he began grooming that boy for the throne. Of course, that all changed when Helseth arrived. Poor Vandus was found dead soon after. Okay. Now I do want to pick the lock on this chest. Even though I think it's probably just potions. I want to steal this gold. There's another passage to the courtyard, but let's talk to Lorena Maria. I wouldn't have expected to see the Nera Vereen here in Mournhold. She has no new spells for us, which is fine. So I guess we'll just chat with her. Background. I am Lorena Maria, priest. Baron Zaya. We were all very excited when the Lady Baron Zaya returned to Mournhold. Of course, she brought her son with her. Still, it is wonderful to have a woman with such charm and grace in the palace again. Helseth. King Helseth is our new king, son of Queen Baron Zaya. I'd like to know what happened to King Athanlethen and to his young protege, Talon Vandus. It all seems a bit suspicious to me. Latest rumors. Did you hear the guards caught and killed the thief who stole the bipolar blade from the Museum of Artifacts? Those artifacts are so valuable that as soon as Tarasa Aram reported the theft, immediate kill-on-sight orders went out to the guards. I don't know why anyone would be so stupid as to steal from the museum. I mean, where could you fence a priceless item like that? Royal Guard. You'll find the Royal Guard around the Royal Palace, mostly. I've heard they're dangerous men. I know I'm going to stay clear of them. Talon Vandis. He was a very popular figure here at Mournhold, with most people at least. King Lethan thought of the boy as a son and was grooming him for the throne. Unfortunately, he met with an accident soon after Helseth arrived in Mournhold. Really a shame. Okay. And we've got another entrance to the guards' quarters. Let's try Baron Zaya's chambers first. Oh, and we can go in. Go figure. Well, let's check things out. Here are Alusana and Baron Zaya. Alrighty. Now let's check things out in here first. That is the same Queen Baron Zaya from all the real Baron Zaya stories we've read across both this game and Skyrim, and the biographies of Baron Zaya as well. We'll talk to you in a minute. I want the gold. I hate it. I'm just gonna have to do that every time, I think. For fuck's sake, come on! Hey, we got one. Got two. Got three. One more chest. And one more opportunity to fail trying to get the stuff inside the chest. And indeed we did. But that's okay. We're close now. Alright. Let's talk to Alusana first. I wouldn't have expected to see the Nerevarine here in Mournhold. Background. I am a royal guard. Dark Brotherhood. You want to go looking for them? It's your funeral. Look, I've heard rumors that they have a hideout in the ruins of Old Mournhold. You can get there through the sewers in the Great Bazaar. Talon Vandis. I've heard of him. Heard he was dead, too. Shame to lose a good soldier, but he should have been more careful. And let's talk to Baron Zaya. Ah, you were the one recently arrived from Vardenfell. What is it you wish to ask? Almalexia. She is one of the Tribunal, the God Kings of Morrowind. She resides in the High Temple here in Mournhold. Background. I am Baron Zaya, Queen Mother. Baron Zaya. I am Baron Zaya. Were you confused about that? Dark Brotherhood. Not a group of people to be taken lightly. Their reach is far and their methods well honed. Take care when dealing with them. Fedris Flair. There is more to Flair than one would think. There are rumors that he was once an assassin. It is fairly widely known that he is the leader of the Hands of Almalexia. This is not a person to be trifled with. Gavis Drin. Drin is the Lord Archcanon of the Mournhold Temple. He possesses great magical skill and is utterly devoted to the goddess Almalexia. Helseth. He is my son. He is also the king of Morrowind. Latest rumors, little advice, little secret. Morrowind lore, Nerevarine. I know a little about the prophecies. I know about you and the temple. Some people in the West set great store in signs and portents, but for thousands of years we Dunmer have had the luxury of being able to speak directly to our gods. We have no need of prophets and distrust anyone who claims to speak for the gods. Royal Guard. Oh, they're my son's personal guard. Effective soldiers from what I've seen of them. Sothisil. Sothisil is one of the original companions of Nerevar who have come to be known collectively as the Tribunal. It is said he is a powerful mage and a wizard with mechanical devices. Little else is known about this reclusive god. Talon Vandis. I'd only met the man once or twice myself, but he left a strong impression. Smart, charismatic, he could have been a leader of our people. Tienius Deletion. Tienius has been my son Helseth's loyal and trusted advisor for many years. He is a skilled warrior and an intelligent man. Do not be fooled by his rough exterior. Tienius is a shrewd man and an excellent judge of character. It is no coincidence my son trusts him as implicitly as he does. All right. Well, thank you, Baron Zaya. Now, we're running low on time, but we're also almost done exploring inside the palace. Let's head to the guards' quarters. Poke around in here. Ervis Verano's chest. Lots of stuff to loot and check out. That's never all that pleasant. Diridini Ferrano's chest. Alusana's chest. Drusus Gratus's chest. Milvila Draylan's chest. Hey, some gold. A Larry Aaron's chest. The Common Tongue, Irano's copy. Well, we can read that, but we don't want to take it off the list, or we don't want to pick it up. Let's read this right quick. This broadsheet is a newsletter copied on cheap paper featuring sensational events in the city of Mournhold. One article describes a list of individuals who died under suspicious circumstances when their interests conflicted with those of a former Prince of the West. The reference is clearly King Helseth, King of Morrowind, formerly Prince Helseth of the Kingdom of Wayrest in the province of High Rock. This copy was found under the pillow on Ivulin Irado's bed. The ownership of the chest at the foot of the bed indicates the ownership of the document. The common tongue. A poet can have no higher purpose than to tell the truth about the human condition. Lord Vivek. Mysteries of the West. I have a little list. They never would be missed. Appearing at the top, three names, Anhar Khajiit Male, Martirius Arruntius Imperial Male, Jusol Astiel Breton Male. What do these three names have in common? All three at one time or another represented an inconvenience to a western noble prince named Helseth. Anhar was an agent for eastern ebony merchants. There was an unfortunate scandal concerning improper contracts offered to Helseth as compensation for his assistance in obtaining ebony import remits from the Imperial Board of Censuses and Excise. Luckily for Prince Helseth, this scandal blew over when no one could be found to testify. Is it just a coincidence that Anhar's health went into a steep decline, just as he was to testify before the Imperial Magistrates? He died a natural death according to the Imperial Coroners. Convenient and timely, perhaps, but natural. Martirius Arruntius was a city alderman of Wayrest. Prince Helseth's liaison with the alderman's married daughter was potentially embarrassing to the prince, especially when Martirius Arruntius forcefully pressed his suit for predatory adultery in Wayrest's courts. Many thought it strange that Martirius Arruntius should suddenly fall ill and die of exhaustion on the eve of the trial. The suit was settled out of court and charges dismissed. The Imperial Coroners ruled that Martirius Arruntius had died a natural death. Convenient and timely, admittedly, but natural. Jusol Astiel was a diplomatic attaché at the High Rock Embassy in Wayrest. Widely rumored to be an intelligence officer, Jusol Astiel was often seen at court, taking a great interest in the affairs of Queen Berenzaya and her family. It is said that Wayrest can be a beastly uncomfortable place in high summer. Perhaps the Breton's constitution was ill-suited to the relentless heat and pestilential swarms of the southern Iliac. Jusol Astiel took suddenly ill one evening, and within 3 days he was dead. Once again, Imperial Coroners ruled that Jusol Astiel had died a natural death. Convenient and timely, yes, but natural. And these, the common tongue notes significantly, are only the A's on the list. Some have quietly suggested that Prince Helseth was the most accomplished and subtle poisoner in the West, but the common tongue has never seen a single scrap of evidence that would prove such an indictment. Admittedly, the absence of such proof could count as qualifying towards the title of a most accomplished and subtle poisoner. And further, the common tongue does not wish to suggest that King Helseth is a poisoner, or that the recent death of King Athenlethens was a poisoning and not a natural death. The common tongue has never seen a single scrap of evidence that would prove such an indictment, and the Imperial Coroners have ruled that Athenlethen died a natural death. See, we got some more small chests here. There's a Larry Aylin that we can speak to her. Just about out of time, but we're also just about done here in the Royal Palace. I wouldn't have expected to see the Nerevarine here in Mournhold. Background, I am a Royal Guard. Okay. There is a path to the Legion Depot. Down here, there's the jail, the courtyard, and over here, Imperial Cult Services. All right, let's go check out the jail, and then we'll be ready to head to the courtyard and make our way out. chest marked evidence. Lock level 50. Alright, that's it for the jail. So now let's head out to the courtyard. There's the main exit. There are two main exits here. We can go out to the temple courtyard, or we can go to Plaza Brindisi Dorome. But before we do any of that, there are two people out here we need to chat with. Let's talk to Calvus Horatius. If you're looking for someone to watch your back, I'm available for hire. Available for hire. For 250 gold, I'll serve as bodyguard and companion for 30 days. I'm strong, and I don't mind heavy loads. I'm healthy and quick to heal. Heal me if you can. Keep me healthy, and you'll get your money's worth, but I won't stand for any abuse. I work for profit. I've got my own gear and gold. If you ever leave me with less profit than my own gear and gold, then I quit immediately and never work for you again. Maybe some other time. You know where to find me. Goodbye. Baron Zaya, Gavistrin, heavy loads. Right, I can show you what I am carrying, and if I'm not encumbered, I'll carry anything you're not strong enough to carry for yourself. Hehe. Just speak to me about the topic companion share, and I'll show you my inventory. You can add or take things as you like, but remember, I work for profit. I've got my own gear and gold. If you ever leave me with less profit than my own gear and gold, then I quit immediately and never work for you again. And one more thing. Continue. Make sure you collect all your own gear from me before my contract expires. After my contract expires, you can't add or remove things from my inventory anymore. Unless you rehire me for a new contract, of course. Contract. I have no current contract. Helseth. Latest rumors. What's the most dangerous thing in Mournhold? Apart from Helseth's royal guards in the hands of Almalexia, which you've got no business fooling with anyway, I'd say the Black Dart Gang. I've had no experience with them personally, but from what I hear, they are really bad news. Black Dart Gang. They're deadly. They look like harmless beggars, and they hang out in the sewers, waiting to ambush some careless adventurer struggling out of the ruins loaded with loot. They use darts, deadly poisons, enchantments, I don't know. Never heard of anything so evil. If you see one, you better run, fast, and carry cure poison and dispel potions. Little advice. If you're looking for excitement and loot, try the sewers. The residential and the temple sewers are two completely separate drainage systems. Use grates in God's Reach and the Great Bazaar to reach the residential sewers, and also in the Royal Palace, I've heard. I don't know about the temple system, probably in the temple itself. The poor and the lawless live under the city, Travis. It's dangerous, but it's the only way to reach the ruins of Old Mournhold, where the real treasure lies. Little secret. Modern Mournhold... we've done that. Profit. I am in this for the money. I won't be robbed. I start with gear worth 500 gold, and with the 250 gold you're paying me. As long as I always have at least that much in gold and goods, I'll serve you according to contract. But if you take any gear or gold from me, I quit. You can take gold or goods from me, but only if you are replacing it with other gold and goods, so my gear and gold are worth 750. Royal Guard. Services. Solstheim, someone in particular. Talon Vandis. And there's one more person to speak to in the courtyard, and that is Flitinius Merrow. Hello, what can I do for you? Almalexia. Almalexia is a member of the Tribunal. She was the wife of Nerevar and one of his most trusted advisors. She resides here in Mournhold and is much loved by the people. Baron Zaya. Ah, the Lady Baron Zaya, a fine, fine woman. It has been my pleasure to have known her as long as I have. Dark Brotherhood. The Dark Brotherhood have a long and interesting history, though a great deal of it still lies shrouded in mystery. What is certain is that they are deadly and remorseless. Steer clear of them at all costs. Phaedrus Lair. My research tells me that Lair has been with the Lady Almalexia for many years now, serving in an official capacity as her steward. What these duties entail is not known to me, but there are rumors that he carries out some of the more unpleasant chores for the goddess. Gavis Drin. Gavis Drin became the Lord Archcanon over 10 years ago, when the former Archcanon died of old age. Drin has spent his life in servitude to the Lady Almalexia, and he has been rewarded with great power. Ghostgate. Ghostgate was built as the gate citadel of the Ghostfence Ordinator and Buoyant Armager garrisons. Now, since you've slain Dagoth Ur and banished the Blight, perhaps they should maintain the garrisons as a tribute to Almsivi and you, and all those who died to save Morrowind. God's Reach. Great Bazaar. Oh. God's Reach is on the western side of the city. There are a number of manors there owned by some of the more wealthy citizens. You'll also find the Craftsman's Hall, which is a fine place to find armor and weapons. They'll even make them to order, provided you have the materials. You can check out the Winged Guar Tavern as well. Not a bad place for a drink, or if you need a place to stay for the night. You might check out the Museum of Artifacts as well. The curator is always trying to add to the collection. Great Bazaar. It's in the eastern section of the Mournhold. You'll find some of the best wares in all of Morrowind on sale there. Check out some of the stores nearby as well. They sell some excellent items. While you're at the bazaar, see if there's a public performance. They can be amusing. Helseth. Helseth is the son of Baron Zaya, former queen of Morrowind, who herself was the niece of King Athenlethen. It is certain that his bloodline is strong. He is a young king, though, and perhaps a bit rash. He does not yet possess his mother's wisdom or his father's courage. Plaza Brindisi de Rome. You'll find the plaza in the southern part of Mournhold. It is a beautiful area, a good place to spend a restful day. Royal Guard. They're an elite group, picked by King Helseth for their bravery and complete devotion to him. Some have been with him since his time in Wayrest. Their leader, Tienius Deletion, is a fine soldier and a good man. Services. Settlements in Morrowind. Slavery. Solstheim, someone in particular, Sothasil. Sothasil is one of the three god kings of Morrowind. While Vivek and Almalexia have traditionally been fairly visible to their followers, Sothasil has been more reclusive. He is known as a great mage and scholar, and is said to live in a clockwork city of his making. Talon Vandis. Yes, I heard the poor man was killed while hunting. Odd, that. He was a powerful warrior and should have been more careful. Rumor has it that Athenlethen was grooming him for the throne. He was Lethen's nephew. I suppose that is a moot point now, though. The Empire. The Empire of Tamriel encompasses the 9 Imperial provinces, Skyrim, High Rock, Hammerfell, Somerset Isle, Valenwood, Elsewhere, Black Marsh, Morrowind, and the ancient Imperial province itself, Cyrodiil. Dating from the first era Cyrodiilic Empire, the Empire is almost 4,000 years ago. But more properly, the current Empire dates from the beginning of the Third Era, and the crowning of Tiber Septim as Emperor of Morrowind over 400 years ago. The current Emperor is Uriel Septim, 24th of the Septim line. Tienius Deletion. Tienius has been with Helseth since he was a child in the Emperor's court. He's a career soldier and has risen through the ranks quickly. Helseth chose him to lead the Royal Guard, not only because he is a fine warrior. Deletion is also a savvy politician, and he is an excellent judge of character. And with that, we've fully explored the Royal Palace. And what I want to do now is head down and check out the palace sewers before we branch out to the rest of the city. So I'm going to head to the basement and to the sewer entrance. But I've been going for over an hour now, so upon reaching that sewer entrance, I'm going to end this video. This has been Let's Play Morrowind. We've arrived in Mournhold, and we've already checked out the Royal Palace. Next time, we'll hit the palace sewers, and then we will get out into the other segments of the city. Until then, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking an ad, liking, sharing, or subscribing, any or all of which will really help me out. Regardless, please know that I really do appreciate the time you spend watching, and hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.